Hello guys, I'm Aris from Hardware Bastards, and today we have a power supply unit which is going against that one. This is the Corsair AX1600i. Currently it is the best power supply unit money can buy, but we have a new challenger today from Wentai. Wentai is an unknown, so far at least, brand, and they came up with a modern platform, a modern and high-end platform, which uses exactly the same technology that Flexsonics put into this PSU. And namely, it has a totem-pole PFC converter. I know this is too technical for most of you. Anyway, this is the Wentai Aidan T1616. I think it's called Aidan because this is the name of its designer, but I'm not dead sure about that. Anyway, 1660 watts, OEM Wentai, efficiency ETA-A plus in the cybernetic scale, and it's certified also as 80 plus titanium. And when it comes to noise, LAMBDA-S plus, meaning that the overall noise output is 35 to 40 decibels. Let's take a look. The box is quite large, you can see. Unbeatable performance. Actually, there's a whole line of digital PSUs. It's that one. 1616, 1388, 1288, 1111, 1888, and 777. Okay, those guys have something. They hold the grudge, I think, to the normal capacities that the PSUs use. I don't know. The first paper that you will see, specifications, output rating, various ISOs, the Wentai logo here. Okay. The PSU is very well protected inside the box. Very well protected. And this is it. Transform. This is the company that provides the technology for the totem-pole PFC converter. Not only the technology, but also the MOSFETs. They are called MOSFETs and not MOSFETs. MOSFETs that use the GaNe technology. The dimensions are large enough, 180 millimeters depth. It is fully modular, as you can see here. And okay, the external build quality looks good enough. This is the monster power cable that uses AWG 12 gauges. Look how thick it is. It's the first time I see such a thick cable used in a desktop power supply unit. And the modular cables. Who it affects to, this PSU? For the moment, it's not sold anywhere as far as I know. But I believe that Wentai built this in order to offer it to major brands like Corsair, for example, or ASUS, why not, in order to have a very high-end PSU in their arsenal. It's good that Wentai went into business because so far only Flexsonics was able to build those totem-pole PFC converters in desktop PSUs. Now, there's also Wentai competition is very good for all of us. If a brand takes this PSU and make it worldwide available, it will refer to highly enthusiast users, of course, and not to the average Joe. It will be very, very expensive. I believe it will be on the same neighborhood with the AX1600i. Now, warranty? I have no clue. No clue. I believe it will be around 10 years, 7 to 10 years. The same with the AX series. Price, as I told you, similar to the Corsair AX1600i, that means over 400 bucks. Maybe more, I'm not sure. It depends on who will take it, which brand will take it, and on the manufacturing scale. Cables. It comes with 2 EPS, 8 PCI Express cables, and the number of peripheral cables are very high, 16 SATA connectors and 8 4-pin Molex connectors. There are so many 4-pin Molex connectors, I don't know even if it's necessary. The cable length. Wentai sent it over to me with short cables, the EPS and PCI Express, they only have 550mm length. Obviously this was done on purpose in order to achieve higher efficiency. The longer the cables, the higher the energy losses, so efficiency goes down. They wanted me to test it and have the best results. You will definitely use this PSU in a cave size chassis, in a very large chassis, because it can power so many components. So it needs to have long cables in order to not fall into any compatibility issues. Also, the distance between the peripheral connectors is too low at only 100 millimeters. It should be at least 150 millimeters. Now, there are no in-cable caps. Wentai thought that they are not needed. In digital PSUs, you don't really need in-cable caps. The internal design and the external, good build quality overall, although I did notice some wire bypasses which indicate that the platform is not into its final stage. Most likely they will do some changes and they won't use those wire bypasses in the final design and the final production. And besides that, the build quality is very high at the internals. They used also very good components, quality components, including many Temicon caps, which belong to the KY and KYA series, which has very good lines of capacitors. And of course, it also uses polymer caps, which are provided by Temicon and NIC. The cooling fan is not a fluid dynamic bearing one, to my surprise, but it uses a double ball bearing. This means increased noise output, but also very high tolerance to tough conditions. And by the word tough conditions, I mean high operating temperatures. The efficiency. This unit has very high efficiency in all load ranges. It scored very high in all tests that I conducted, but the 20 watt load test where the efficiency, I don't know why it was very low, it was about 69, close to 70 actually percent, while with 40 watt loads it easily exceeded 80%. Now, with 2% of the PSU's max rated capacity, the efficiency is sky high. It's the highest I have ever seen so far. Imagine how tough it is for such a high capacity PSU with only 2% of its max power to achieve such high efficiency. I believe this is due to the digital design, actually the semi-digital design. The overall efficiency. This unit achieves a higher overall efficiency than the Corsair AX1600i. That says it all, I think. Vampire power, very low levels of vampire power, and this is why the 5 VSB efficiency, especially under very light loads, is sky high. The 5 VSB circuit in this unit is among the most efficient I have seen so far. Load regulation, it's tight at plus 12 volt, not so tight at 5 volt and 5 VSB, and unfortunately quite loose at 3.3 volt. Let's go now to ripple suppression. It's good. It's quite good, actually. But when you have to fight with this unit, good enough won't cut it. So it could be better at 12 volt, at plus 12 volt. And actually, if Wentai manages to break down the ripple suppression on this rail, then I believe that this unit will be very, very close to Corsair's top dog. Now it has 25.5 millivolts ripple at plus 12 volt, while the AX1600i is about 10 millivolts. So you can see that the difference is quite high. And of course it affects the overall performance score of this unit. Another problem, major issue according to the ATX spec at least, is in the DC power sequencing test that I conducted, where the 3.3 volt rail is higher than the 5 volt rail during the PSU's startup phase. The transient response is of huge importance because it's the closest thing to real life scenarios. In the 12 volt rail is very, very good, and actually it's also very good at the 5 volt and 5 VSB rails, and the 3.3 volt rail is satisfactory. The hold up time is very long thanks to the massive capacity of the bulk caps that this unit has, and it's longer even than the Corsair AX1600i. And another advantage here is that the power OK signal is accurate. The in-rush currents are at normal levels, especially if we take into account the size of the bulk caps. Another issue, EMI emissions. Especially at low frequencies, the EMI spikes go over the roof. That is a problem for Wentai, which needs addressing. Although the EMI filtering stage has all necessary components, still EMI suppression is not good at all. The fan RPM and noise under high temperatures, the semi-passive mode lasts up to 800 watts, but afterward the fan speed increases notably, and this means that the fan can be really loud. They use a very strong fan into this unit. It's rated about 1 ampere. This is the strongest fan I ever seen in a desktop PSU. Also, it has a semi-passive operation, but unfortunately it's not selectable, so you cannot deactivate the semi-passive mode, which is a disadvantage in my book. Now, the fan speeds and noise under normal temperatures, by normal I mean 30 to 32 degrees. The AX1600i is notably quieter at 23.7 dBA overall, while the Aidan unit is close to 37 dBA. This is a very high difference, and it simply means that this unit will be noisy if you stress it enough. On the contrary, the AX1600i is not noisy at all. Protection features evaluation. This unit has multiple 12 volt rails. Also the Corsair unit has multiple. The OCP, the overcurrent protection, is set a little higher than the ideal one threshold, which is about 130%. The overtemperature protection is reasonably set given the semi-passive mode that this unit has, and all the other important protection features are present and work pretty well. I saw some FLIR images of the internals with a PSU operating at half load for 10 minutes, and as you can see, the temperatures are very low. Of course, I expect very low temperatures because the efficiency is super high levels, and this clearly shows that the fan profile, the fan speed profile, can be much more relaxed and not so aggressive. Skipping to the overall performance, this is very, very high. Actually, this is one of the best PSUs in terms of overall performance that I have tested so far. And I believe that if Wentai brings the Ripple on the 12 volt rail even lower, close to 10 millivolts, then it can meet eye to eye Corsair's high end unit, the AX1600i. Bottom line, this is a great power supply, which with a little more work, it can beat Corsair's AX1600i, which currently puts to shame every other high end PSU out there. Wentai has a killer platform on its hands, but think is how it will take advantage of it, and of course, how much those guys plan to charge for it. The pros of this unit: 12 AWG AC power cord, good build quality, tolerant to high operating temperatures, very high overall performance, sky high efficiency, very efficient 5 VSB rail, over 70% efficiency with 2% load, tight 12 volt load regulation, good ripple suppression, good transient response, especially at the 12 volt rail, low in-rush currents, low vampire power, low hold-up time, accurate power OK signal, large number of provided cables and connectors, and 2 EPS and 8 PCI Express connectors, along with a huge amount of peripheral ones. The cons: short EPS and TX cables, at least in my sample. High EMI spikes, especially at low frequencies. The power on time is greater than 150 milliseconds, and this can create problems with some mainboards, compatibility issues. The PSU cannot handle full load with 100 volt input, and also it cannot deliver 110% load with 115 volt input. This is an issue, and Wentai should look into this. Noise operation, low power factor readings with 230 volt input, not that tight load regulation, a 3.3 volt and 5 VSB, non-selectable semi-passive operation. Ideally, this unit should have PWM controlled fan. All peripheral connectors should have at least 150 millimeters distance. And finally, the DC power sequential problem that I noticed where the 3.3 volt rail is higher during the startup phase than the 5 volt rail. That is all. Thank you for watching another one video. If you like it, please leave a comment, subscribe to our channel, and tell us what else you would like to see from us. Bye bye.